A very good morning to all of you students. I hope you are very well. So let's continue with the second part of geography chapter life in desert region. In part 1 we have studied about the Sahara Desert. We all know Sahara Desert is the biggest desert of the world and also the hot desert. Okay. And in part 2 we will study about the Ladakh Desert. Okay. Without any delay let's continue with this chapter. Now we will talk about where Ladakh is situated. Ladakh is situated in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir in country of India. And where it lies in eastern part, it lies to the north of the Himalayan mountain range. And it is bounded by or it is covered up by the Karakoram range of mountain in the north and the Zaskar mountain range is in the south. So here on your screen you can see the cold desert of the Ladakh, some areas. You can also see some animals used for transportation, and basically it is a very barren land, means you won't be able to carry out the agriculture process here. Okay, let's talk about the land. So basically the Ladakh is situated in high mountain range or in the higher mountain area. Ladakh desert is cold desert because at high altitude you will also see the ice, and it is a barren desert. What is barren desert? You won't find any kind of agriculture activity or human inhabitation there. It is also known as the moonland or the broken moon, which means that it is very remote and inaccessible, means reaching there is not easy as compared to reaching to a grassland or a plains. K2, it is the highest mountain peak here and the world's second highest peak, which is 8611 meters high. And where does it lie? In Karakoram range. Because of Karakoram range it is named as K2. And if we talk about the Ladakh range, it has an average height of 6000 meter, and this is not so important peak you will find there. There are many mountain passes or mountain ways which provide access to Ladakh, means by using various mountain ways or mountain roads you will reach Ladakh in Karakoram. The ranges are Karakoram range and Jojila pass. They are the very important and famous range passes. And the region, this region or this area is drained by the river, or the river which flows here are Indus and its tributaries, that is Shog, Zaskar, Nibra and Suru. And if we talk about these rivers, they have deep cut valley and rocky desert surface. You will find many ice glaciers in this region. Basically the most of the glaciers are found in Karakoram mountain range. So here is you will find there's a motorbike and there's a road on which driving can be done, and the person goes there either by two wheelers or four wheelers depending upon their need. And also you will find on the right there is some lake there. Let's talk about the climate. As Ladakh is a desert area, so it will face extreme climate. In summer the days are warm because the sun shines very brightly, and if we talk about the nights, they are very cool, and the humidity or the sweating is very low here. And if we go in winter, it is very severely cold, very cold temperature. As you know that the Ladakh desert lies to north of Himalayas, so the climate will in winter will remain cold. When these wind cross the mountains, and reaching to Ladakh is very negligible, and so during the winter we will face very huge amount or very heavy amount of snowfall. So on the bottom of screen, you will see ice mountains there in the Ladakh region. Let's talk about the natural vegetation and wildlife there. As there is very little rainfall, the vegetation or plantation in Ladakh is very low, not much plantation. And although there are some trees like willow, cypress, elm, juniper and poplar, they can be found in valleys and the lower slope or the downer slope of the mountain. And as we go to the higher slopes, you will find grasses and shrubs in more amount of quantity. If we talk about the wildlife or the wild animals there, then it consists of Tibetan antelopes, wild sheep, wild goat, yaks and Tibetan wild ass known as kyang. And the tourists prefer to ride on yaks, you will see on the YouTube video. And the birds like pigeon, carrion crow, chukar and the golden eagle, they can be also found in Ladakh region. So here on your screen you can see the Ladakh region, where not much of vegetation can be found, little amount of vegetation in the vast area of Ladakh. Let's talk about the human activities. What humans do? They carry out animal rearing, agriculture and tourism. These are the important occupation in the Ladakh region of the people. You will find yak, goats and sheep. They are being reared and raised in the on the mountain pasture. Yak is very useful animal. It provide milk, meat and wool. Also the people used to have ride on yak, basically the tourist. Here we will find the wool of the very finest or very good quality known as pashima, also available here. And Ladakh region is very famous for all over the world in its shawl, blankets and carpets. So here on the left screen you will see people riding bike. Basically most of the people used to ride the bullet, Royal Enfield bullet, to reach to Ladakh. Okay. Human activities. Agriculture is practiced in the valleys and on the lower side of the mountains. And the which crops are grown here in summer season from May to September? Because the temperature is high and suitable for crop growth. And crops like wheat, barley, other vegetables and fruits like apple, apricots, walnuts and grapes. These are the crops which are grown here. And in winter, because weather is extremely cold and agriculture is not at all possible. And during winter season, people used to engage themselves in handicraft activities like weaving and carpet making, shawl making, etc. Also minerals like sulfur and borax, they are found in Ladakh region, but there is not any big industries or large industry for the mineral extraction in Ladakh. Tourism is very important as the part of economy in Ladakh. The stark mountains landscape means the landscape of the Ladakh, the mountain region of the Ladakh, attracts tourists from domestic as well as international. And the government also promotes tourism here. How it promotes tourism in Ladakh? The government organized the Sindhu festival in June every year to promote tourism in Ladakh region. Let's talk about the city and transport. And because it is situated in the mountain region, so the rugged terrain or uneven terrain is there. It result in difficult in developing good transport region in Ladakh, system in Ladakh. Only few motorable roads on which the driving is possible of two-wheelers, four-wheelers, buses, etc. And the Leh, it is very important town of Ladakh. It is also the administrative as well as commercial center of this region. How Leh is connected to Kashmir Valley? It is connected by a road which passes through Jozila Pass, which is important tourist attraction. And there is also another road which passes through Khardungala Pass, which connects Leh to Srinagar. And the very important highway, Manali Leh Road, it is the highest motorable road in the world, means situated in high altitudes and driving is possible. Kargil, we all know that Kargil is important town where India got victorious in the war of 1999 with its neighbor Pakistan. Both Leh and Kargil have air connectivity. So here on your screen you can see the motorable transport in the Ladakh region being driven on the roads. People life in the Ladakh. The harsh physical condition. We all know that in desert, and basically in the cold desert, the physical condition is very harsh, and due to which people in Ladakh have to carry out their living in such a harsh climate. They have to adapt the lifestyle so that it can suit with their surroundings, to nearby areas. Houses are built in small group or cluster along the streams or nearby to the rivers so that farming is possible, or the houses are made nearby to the roads. How the houses are made? They are made with the help of sun-dried bricks, and they have flat roofs. And the people of Eastern Ladakh, are Tibetan Buddhist. Ladakhi is the very common language spoken there. There are many Buddhist monasteries known as Gompas in this region. And the important one of the important Buddhist monasteries is Hermes Gompa, a very famous monastery. So here on your screen you can see people enjoying due to a festival being organized, performing various activities. In the Western Ladakh, people are mostly Muslim, and they speak, which language they speak? The Balti language. Balti language, okay. And the government has taken many important measures so that it can improve the living condition of people in Ladakh by promoting tourism, by promoting the handicraft industry, etc. The transportation and communication system is being developed over the time. New irrigation facility also been provided with the help of hydroelectric power potential and been promoted at a very large scale. And in August 2019, after the removal of Article 370, Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir were declared as two separate union territory. Okay students, so in part 2 what we have discussed and read about the Ladakh region, which is the cold desert, how the human activities perform, what is the transportation system, how people live there, what is the climate. Okay, I hope you have understood this video. Read the chapter carefully, listen to this video very carefully so that you will understand this chapter without any confusion. Till then, thank you and take care.